Greetings to everyone in the name of Jesus. I thank God in the name of Jesus for giving me an opportunity to minister to you. Also, I am thankful to all the television viewers. May God speak into your life. God has given me a word to share with you. That is from the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3. So, the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3. The 20th words, hallelujah. So before coming into the word, let us close our eyes to pray for a moment. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for this presence, your presence released over this media. May everyone be healed and everyone be delivered, and only the name of Jesus be exalted. Fill everyone with your Holy Spirit. I pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, touch everyone. May this word speak into their lives. I submit myself to you. And let this word bring them healing, deliverance, everything. Thank you, Lord, for everything in the name of Jesus. Amen. So once again, I am thankful to all the television viewers. So I'm going to read that book of Zephaniah chapter 3, the 20th verse. It says, at that time I will bring you back, even at the time I gather you, for I will give you fame and praise among all the peoples of the earth when I return your captives before your eyes, says the Lord. So it is God Jehovah who is speaking. God Jehovah is saying in this book through the prophet that he is going to restore everyone. Anyone who is saying that I have lost everything, this word will bring you deliverance. Because here this verse, in this verse, God Jehovah is saying that I will bring you back. So today, if you say amen, wherever you are, if you say amen, God is going to bring you back from the captivity. God is going to heal you, and God is going to give you fame, and he is going to give you praise. So this world will give you deliverance. So many people in this world are worried because, you know, the pandemic, the COVID is spread throughout the nations, and people are worried. They do not know what to do. Many people lost their business. Many people lost their lives. Many of them are still suffering. They cannot even come out of it. They are surviving very hard. So today, Lord is telling, I will bring you back. So when you see, you can see all the people are wearing the mask. They are keeping a distance, so they are keeping social distance, and everyone are using the sanitizer. So their life is not like before. Now it has started almost, it has become, this is the second year, and people are much worried about the pandemic. They do not know when it will cease, but God has promised that I will bring you back. So this is the word that God is speaking to you. So maybe the people of the world, they do not know. The scientists do not know. The astrologers do not know, because God had hid his plan to all these people. But he has revealed to us, to his beloved children, to his apostles, to his prophets, he has revealed. And also now we have got this word from the book of Zephaniah that Lord is confirming that he will bring you back. So there is a life in you that you will enjoy your life, and from what you lost, everything is going to be restored. This is the promise of the Lord. So here this verse is saying, at that time I will bring you back. Do you have any idea about the at that time? God is saying at that time. That means when God is going to honor you. God is going to honor you, because all the promises you that you have heard from the beginning, at the time when you took baptism, at the time when you received Jesus Christ as his Savior, from that time onwards you have been hearing many prophecies, and till this time no prophecies has come into your life. But today this word is saying that at that time, that means the fulfillment of your promises. God has kept a time for the fulfillment of your promises. You know, God spoke to Joseph in his dreams that his servants will come and bow down before him. So there was a time for that. It took many years, and before that he had to pass through many persecutions. He wasn't thrown in the dry well. He was there in the prison. So in order to have that promise to come to pass into his life, he had to face many difficulties. Likewise, maybe you have many prophecies. You have many prophecies, but till this time, these prophecies have not come into your life. Do not be upset, says the Lord, because the Lord is saying there is restoration. God is guaranteeing you that there is restoration. That is the book of Zephaniah 3:20. It says, at that time, I will bring you back. That means when the time of your promises are going to be fulfilled, there is a time kept for your promises to be fulfilled. At that time, he will bring you back. That's what I will bring you back. And not only he is bringing you back, he is going to gather everyone dear to you. Maybe you are alone, your children are somewhere else, and your wife somewhere else. Maybe you are scattered. So I sense those who are watching, some of you are having their family away and you are alone, you are isolated. But God has a plan in your life. That's why you are isolated. God has a purpose in your life. That's why you are isolated. But when the time comes, that's what it's saying, at that time, I will gather you. I will gather you. That is the promise of God. You know, Joseph was isolated. I told you that he had great promise that his servants will come and bow down. But he was isolated in the prison. He was there for many years where his family were far away. But the promise came to him and God gathered everyone together. So here this was, even at the time I gather you. So he will bring you back. He will gather every one of you. This is the promise of the Lord. And it's saying, I will give you fame and praise. That means God is going to make you famous. This word, the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, 20 says, God is going to give you famous. How many of you believe that you are going to become famous? Maybe you are a shy person. From your childhood till this time, you are a shy person. You might be wondering how you will become famous. A shy person cannot become famous. Only those who are very smart, or the people say he is very smart, he is very over smart. Such people will become, some of them will become famous because they have the ability to do, they have the ability to speak. But for a child of God, these things doesn't matter. It is God who is lifting a child of God. So what is this verse saying? This verse is saying, I will give you fame. So God is going to give you fame. He is going to make you famous. And he is going to establish you. When he establishes you, you will become famous. Maybe you are isolated in the house. You are locked down in the house. And nobody doesn't know. And you may be shy to go out and face the people. But today I tell you, God is going to make you famous. When God gives you fame, no one can you inside a room. You know, the light of Jesus, when shines upon a person, that light cannot be hidden in a place, in a bath. It will come out. It will come out, and all the world will come to know. So today, God is going to give you fame, and He is going to honor you. He is going to establish you. And moreover, He is going to give you praise. You know, unless God gives you praise, you cannot praise God. If God gives you praise in your mouth, you will praise God. And when He gives you praise, everyone will praise you because of God. Everyone will honor you because of God. So this is what the verse is saying, for I will give you fame and praise. If God gives you fame, you will become famous. And you don't have to try hard or create something to make you more fame. You only sit, even when you sleep, even when you are somewhere hiding. But if God gives you fame, automatically you will be famous. And also, if God gives you praise, even if you are inside the room, locked down, everyone will praise you. That is the power of the word of God. So this word is saying that I will give you praise. I will give you fame. And I will bring you back. And I will gather you. So this is the guarantee of God. That this is the promise of God. How many of you know that you are going to become famous? I told you that the pandemic is spread everywhere, and everyone are wearing the mask. People are running after seeking the injections, and people are after taking care of themselves. They are isolated, they are in quarantine. But I tell you, there's a time that everything is going to come to an end, and God is going to honor you, because we have the promise. We are separated from the world. And you know, how many of you know that you are going to become famous? I prophesy in the name of Jesus by this word, that this word is saying, I will give you fame and praise among all the peoples of the earth. So it is saying, God is going to make you famous among all the peoples of the earth. All the peoples of the earth means throughout the nations. That means you will be known, you will be famous throughout the nations. And nobody will be there in the earth who doesn't know you. If God gives you fame, you will be known by every person. That is the power of the word of God. So God is going to make you famous. He is giving you fame, and He is giving you praise. So everyone will praise you because of God. So God is going to do greater things in your life. He is going to do greater things in your life. He is going to do miracles in your ministry. Maybe you are a minister, and maybe you are a pastor. You have only a few members in your church. But when God gives you fame, people from far away will come into your church. If you advertise about your ministry, about your church, through the television or everywhere, nobody will come. But when God gives you fame, even if you don't advertise, because God gives you fame, every people from far away will come to your church, to your ministry. Maybe you are a doctor, you are practicing as a physician, and no patients are coming. But when God gives you fame, the patients from far away will come into your clinic. Maybe you are a teacher, and there are no students in your class. Maybe you are taking tuition classes. There are no pupils in the tuition class. But when God gives you fame, the children will come far away. Maybe you are a shopkeeper, and the business is not going well. Maybe you are having an agency. The business is not running very well. Maybe it is running in very loss, or it is just average. But when God gives you fame, when God gives you fame, your business will be known throughout the world. That's what the verse is saying, among all the peoples of the earth. You know, there are many businessmen in the world. There are many great ministers in the world. They are all established. It is the grace of God. So, among them, there are Gentiles also. But the Gentiles don't have an eternal life. But the children of God, when God gives fame, along with the fame in this world, along with the praise that is receiving from this earth, they will also have the eternal life. That is the difference between the Gentiles and the children of God. This is not my subject. I'm not going into that. So today I'm speaking that there is restoration in your life. Anyone is saying that I have nobody, I have lost everything, but there is God in heaven. God Jehovah is his name. He is the God of Israel. He is the God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. He is going to bring you back. He is going to gather your family, and he is going to give you fame and praise, and he is going to honor you among all the peoples of the earth. So you should not have to strive hard. You only just believe in this word, and by the grace of God, you will be established. When God established Samuel the prophet, none of his words came to fall down. Likewise, when God gives you fame, nobody can put any shame on you, because it is God who is going to give you fame. So when God works in you, no one will come and put an hindrance. No enemy will come into your life, and God will do greater things in your life. He is going to bless your children. He is going to do miracles in your children. I see the restoration in many of you. Many of you, those who are watching, there is a restoration. I see many of you, your families are gathered, and God is bringing back everyone. God is going to increase the anointing of everyone. Somebody has lost the eyesight. Somebody has lost the visions. But God is going to restore the visions, the insight, everything. So there will be an increase in anointing. Maybe you have spoken in tongues before, but now you cannot speak in tongues. Today God is restoring everything. What you lost, you are going to restore everything. So God is going to make you famous and establish you and increasing the anointing in you. And the power of the Holy Spirit will come upon you. And when you pray, people will be delivered. When you minister, people will be healed. And when you open your mouth and prophesy, things will be created. So miracles after miracles, your life is going to change, because it is God who is working in you. God is going to lift your children also. God is going to bless your family also. You know, there was a boy. He was a shepherd. He was looking after his father's sheep, but God decided to make him famous. And the anointing oil was sent to David by the prophet Samuel. And he anointed Samuel, and he became the king of Israel, and he became famous. So when God decides to give you fame, he will bring somebody for that. He will raise some persons for that. And Samuel was the prophet, used to anoint David. And David had to face many things in his life. But since he worshipped God, he loved God, God honored him. So his life was very blessed. God began to bless him in every area, because he was given the praise. That's why when he was in the forest hiding from his father-in-law Saul, he was praising God. Most of the psalms are praises. They're all songs. So because it is God who has given him praise. So today I tell you, God is going to give new song into your mouth. Into your mouth he is giving you praise, new song. And he is going to honor you. He is going to establish you. So do not look back. Do not be upset, because God has a plan in your life. And He is going to increase the anointing. And your life is going to change. Your character is going to change. And your personality is going to change, because God has decided to bring you back, to restore you. And He is going to anoint you more. He is purifying you. And He is going to bless you in every area of your life. So you should not be upset. Whatever things that come in on the way, you should not be upset. So I am going to pray for you. So let us close our eyes to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, the word that you gave to me, I have spoken, I have shared with your children. And may this word bring deliverance, healing. This word says that you are going to restore. You are going to bring back. The word says that you are going to bless them. You are going to gather everyone who have been scattered. This word says that you are going to give everyone fame and praise. And also you are going to honor everyone among all the peoples of the earth. May this word come to pass in everyone who is viewing this message, everyone who is watching this message. May this word come to pass in their lives. If anyone is having any disease in the body, right now be healed in the name of Jesus. Every bronchitis is healed in the name of Jesus. Every arthritis is healed in the name of Jesus. Every lung infection is healed in the name of Jesus. Every cancer is healed in the name of Jesus. Lord, bless everyone. Fill everyone with your anointing. Fill everyone with your Holy Spirit. I pray in the name of Jesus. Touch everyone, Father. Thank you, Lord, for touching everyone. Bless everyone, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. So, you believe this word. This word is going to come to pass in your life. There is a restoration. Maybe you are backsliding. But when God decides to bring you back, He will bring you back. You know, there was Abraham and Lot. Lot was not a devotee of God. He followed Abraham in search of blessing. And he lost his relationship with God when he was in Sodom and Gomorrah. He was not having intimate relationship with God even before, but when he was there in Sodom and Gomorrah, he lost every chance of having intimacy with God. But God found grace in him. He found favor in him, and he sent the angels to deliver him from the wicked people of Sodom and Gomorrah. So we can see that. So the same God will send angels in your life. The angels will come and gather your family. Maybe your children, wife are in different places, but the angels are coming. God is sending the angels to gather your family, and He is going to give you fame from heaven. So your life will be changing. Your address will be changing. Your attitude will be changing. Your language will be changing. Your dress code will be changing. And what you speak also, that will bring changes, because it is the great God who has done great things in your life. So you will see that. Maybe things are not going according to your plan, but I tell you, things are going according to God's plan. So you must know the will of God. God has a plan for you, and God is going to lift you up. So do not be worried. You know, when you read the Bible, you can see you have heard of the story of Jabez. He was born in pain, so his mother called him Jabez. But God honored him because he prayed to God. He was sure that God will bless him, honor him. So he prayed to God and God heard his prayer. Today I tell you, whatever problems you have, do not be upset, because God is going to lift you up. He is going to give you fame. He is going to give you praise. He is going to bring you back. And he is going to restore you. So very long time you have been stagnant, and everyone may be wondering at you. Everyone are looking at you. But today I tell you, I prophesy in the name of Jesus, that the time has come for God to lift you up. And God is going to take you to the nations. You will go from one country to another country. You will preach the word of God to many nations, to many races. And God will establish you, because he has promised that he is going to restore you. So whatever things negative come in your life, you should not be upset, because a greater anointing is going to be released. You know why this all this pandemic and everything is come? Because after this time, after that's what the verse is saying, at that time. So after everything, God removes this pandemic from the surface of the earth, God is going to bring you up. He is going to restore you. And then everyone who rejected you, who did not accept you, who laughed at your gospel, are coming to know that you are called and chosen by God Jehovah. So God has a plan in your life. Whatever things that comes in your life, now you wait and see. Wait like Joseph. He waited for many years. If you ask Joseph what you were doing all this time, he will say, I was strengthening my inner man by believing in God and praising God. So it is your duty at this time. You are waiting for a restoration. It is your duty that you have to wait for the Lord. At this time, you have to give praise to God. And God will put fame in you. And he will give you fame. And he will give you praise. And the time is coming. Very surely I say in the name of Jesus, that whatever you do, that will be blessed. And God is going to lift your family also. He is going to bless your family also. Your children are also lifted up. Your wife, your husband, and everyone connected with you. Your parents are, everyone are going to honor because of you. Because you passed through many tribulations. So may God bless everyone by this word. I am also thankful to all viewers, television viewers. May God bless everyone. In Jesus' name, amen.